ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. All praise is due to Allah. We laud Him, beseech His help, and in Him we seek forgiveness. And we seek the refuge of Allah from the mischiefness of our souls and the wrongdoings of all of our actions. Whoever Allah guides, no one can lead Him astray. And whoever Allah leaves to be left astray, no one will be able to guide him. And I bear witness that there is nothing worthy of worship as a deity except Allah. He is alone, He has no partners. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is His abd and His rasul. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala has allowed the human being to come into this existence by agency of two other created things. Those two created things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, except for one instance in the history of mankind, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed Isa to be born without the agency of a father. As for all other human beings, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed us to come to this world by agency of two human beings, your mother and your father. And pertaining to those two human beings, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has enjoined on us some duties that unfortunately many of us have been neglectful in. We live in this country called the United States of America, where we find innumerable senior citizens' homes. We find innumerable old folks' homes. We find many situations in this country, here in the United States, where people, after their parents, one or both of them, took care of them, nourished them, cherished them, fed them, clothed them, gave them shelter. We find in this country, unlike any other country, children casting their parents to the street, literally. Casting their parents, one or both of them, to the street, literally. Where we find these places filled with uncared for parents. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has joined obedience and respect and kindness of the parent, those two creatures that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has allowed you who are listening to me, you who are looking at me on this minbar, myself and all of us, except for Isa ibn Maryam, to come through to these two human beings. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِذَا قَضَى رَبُّكَ, when your Lord has determined, أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّهِ, He has determined and made it obligatory on you and me to worship Him and only Him. Your Lord, my Lord, has made it obligatory on us to worship only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Him. وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّهِ, that you and I should only worship Him, and this is the reason why we were created, to worship Allah. And then Allah connects our parents to the worship of Him, that nothing is higher than the worship of Allah, or nothing is close to the worship of Allah in terms of the rights of human beings, other than respecting and being kind and being generous and being honorable to your parents. Allah says, أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّهُ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا, and that you should be kind to your parents, that you should honor your parents. How could it be that we Muslims who read the Quran, and we hope that this month that is coming, the month of Ramadan, that we will continue to read the Quran and try to read it in its entirety, as the people before us used to do, and trying to finish the Quran in the month of Ramadan, that when you come across these verses, that we come across reading these verses or hearing these ayats from Allah, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا, that we can treat them unkindly. Even if they are mushrikun, even if they're kafirun, even if they're Jehovah's Witnesses, or followers of Louis Farrakhan, or atheists, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes no distinction in the kind treatment of the parents by His statement, وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا, and to treat them kindly. This is a commandment from the Lord of the world, who allows you to come by way of those two creatures, your mother and your father. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam was asked by a man, Man abarru, who is it that has the most place of respect? Who is it that should be treated the kindest? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ummuk, your mother. And for those of us who Allah tabarak wa ta'ala has allowed their mother to still survive and to live, we need to listen to this hadith from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. ثُمَّ قَالْ مَنْ أَبَرُّ. Then he said, who then should have the most honor and respect and kindness? The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said for the second time, أُمُّكَ, your mother. Then the man said it again, ثُمَّ مَنْ أَبَرُّ. Then who? Who is the one who should deserve the most respect and honor and kindness? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said it again, أُمُّكَ, your mother, three times. And when the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam mentions something in third, this is to call our attention to how important it is and how serious it is with Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. And then the man asked the Prophet again, ثُمَّ مَنْ. Then after that, whom? And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, أَبُوكَ, your father. Again on the authority of Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu, in a hadith that is sahih collected by Imam Muslim, where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَا يَجْزِي وَلَدٌ وَالِدًا, that no child will be recompensed, he will not be able to fulfill the right of his father, he will not be able to fulfill the right of his father, the one whom the Prophet mentioned in the fourth case, after three times mentioning the mother, to show the position of the father. لَا يَجْزِي وَلَدٌ وَالِدًا وَفِي رِوَايَةٍ وَالِدَهُ, in another narration, his father. That no child will be able to be able to give their father his due right. In other words, there's nothing that you'll be able to do that will give him his haq, his right and fullness. إِلَّا يَجِدَهُ أَنْ يَجِدَهُ مَمْلُوكًا فَيَسْتَيْرَهُ فَيَشْتَرِيَهُ فَيَعْتِقَهُ, except that he found his father a slave, possessed by someone, owned by someone as a abd mamluk, and then he purchased his father and then he set him free. That will be the only way you can give your father his right back, to show the position of your father, not in Islam, your father, period, mutlaqan, unrestricted, no matter what he may be. Even if your father was the Pope in Rome, even if your father was Drew Ali, that pagan, even if your father was Elijah Muhammad Al-Kadhab, the lying prophet, false prophet, if your father was a homosexual, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's prophet has told us that the only way you can be compensated, the only way you can give him his true right, is that if you found him a slave, purchase him from the slave owner, and then set him free. Brothers and sisters in Islam, this thing of birrul walidain, of treating our parents kindly, is a very, very serious issue. How could it be that a Muslim, not a kafir, a Muslim who reads the book of Allah, who reads the authentic hadith from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, strike his mother? How could it be that a Muslim who reads the book of Allah, praying five prayers a day, and reads the narration from the Sahaba on how they treated their parents, use profanity at their father? Even if their mother and their father curse Allah, even if their mother and father curse Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and said things about the Prophet which are reprehensible, how could it be that you would disrespect your mother and father? The best thing that we should do is to walk away from them and still say a kind word. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has warned us in His book, فَلَا تَنْهَرْهُمَا, and don't repulse them. وَقُلْ لَهُمَا قَوْلًا كَرِيمًا, and say a word that is kind to them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us, وَلَا تَنْهَرْهُمَا, and don't repulse them, meaning don't even turn away from them with an ugly face. In the same ayah, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala says, وَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفٍّ, and I hope that this microphone will be able to pick up what is the meaning of أُفٍّ in the Arabic language. I hope that this microphone is sensitive enough so that you brothers and especially the sisters of Sayyid can listen to what this word uff in the Quran means. When Allah says, وَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا uff, the meaning of uff, the highest form of uff, not the lowest, the highest form of this word uff, at ta'fif, in the English language is this sound. Please listen closely, brothers and sisters. Open your ears to this expression that if you say just this to your parents, you have committed a major sin. An example of the highest form of oof is this sound. If you just say, sucking your teeth to your mother and your father, even if they tell you to take out the garbage, even if they tell you to wash the dishes, and you're 80 years old, and you carry out the act, and you say, you have committed a sin. A major sin. This is the position of our parents in Islam, brothers and sisters. This is the position of your mother and father, no matter what they may be. Sikh, Hindu, Buddhist, whatever. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us, وَاخْفِضْ لَهُمَا جَنَاحَ الظُّلِّ مِنَ الرَّحْمَةِ وَقُلْ رَبِّ ارْحَمْهُمَا كَمَا رَبَّيَانِي صَغِيرًا. And lower the wing of humility to them out of mercy. And make the dua for them, even if they're kafir, even if they're mushrikan, kafiran, even if they're fajiran, even if they're criminals, kafirs, mushrik. وَخْفِضْ لَهُمَا جَنَاحَ الظُّلْ مِنَ الرَّحْمَةِ وَقُلْ رَبِّ ارْحَمْهُمَا كَمَا رَبَّيَانِ صَغِيرًا. Lower the wing of humility to them out of mercy and make this dua for your pagan mother and father. The only dua after guidance that is legal in Islam. Oh my Lord, cherish them, have mercy on them as they cherished and had mercy on me when I was young. Some of us have lost our fathers, and there's nothing that we can do anymore. If your father was a Muslim and you lost your father, the only thing that you can do for him is make dua for him. And that won't even count unless you're righteous. Because if you mistreated your mother and your father while they were alive and they were Muslim, and your father and or your mother died, the only way you can benefit them in your dua is that if you treated them kindly. Because if you didn't treat them kindly, that means you're wicked and you're not righteous. And the righteous child's dua is a benefit for their parents. But if you weren't righteous in this life, and your father who's a Muslim died, or your mother who's a Muslim died, then even your dua won't be any benefit to them. Simply because you committed sins like disrespecting your mother and your father. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has explained to us, brothers in Islam, has explained to us sisters in Islam in this precious hadith collected by Imam Muslim on the authority of Abu Huraira, رَغِمَ أَنْفُ ثُمَّ رَغِمَ أَنْفُ ثُمَّ رَغِمَ أَنْفُ. May he have dust on his nose. May he have dust on his nose. May he have dust on his nose. May she have dust on her nose. This is an expression in the Arabic language which means, may he be humiliated. May he be humiliated. May he be humiliated. مَنْ أَدْرَكَ أَبَوَيْهِ. Whoever finds his parents عند الكبر أحدهما أو كليهما فلم يدخل الجنة. Whoever finds his parents, both of them or one of them, when they reach old age, he will not be able to enter Jannah. Why? It's because he disrespected his mother and his father. As the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said in another narration collected by Ashab al-Sunan, ثلاث لا يدخل الجنة. Three people won't enter into Jannah. The first one on the list that the Prophet mentioned, is that the person who commits shirk? Is that the person who sells crack? Is that the person who gambles? Is that the person who commits zina? Is that the person who steals? Is that the person who beats his wife, even though all of these things and more are haram? The three people and the top on the list that the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam mentioned are those people that won't go into his Jannah, al-aq bil-walidain. The person who disrespects, the person who is unkind, the person who is disobedient to their parents. I repeat, even if your parents are mushrikun. But if they try to make you commit the shirk, then you don't obey them. If they try to make you commit kufr, then you don't obey them. But anything other than that, anything beneath that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has enjoined on you and me, brothers and sisters in Islam, to obey and to respect his parents. If you're 30 or 40 or 50 or 60 or 70 years old right now, and your parents, after the salah is over, because the salah is the most beloved action to Allah, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked, أَيُّ الْعَمَلْ أَحَبَّ إِلَى اللَّهِ تَعَالَى. Which of the actions is most beloved to Allah the Most High? Which one? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, As-salatu ala waqtiha. Salah in its prescribed time. Thumma ayyu. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked, in which? He said, birrul walidain. So we know from this hadith that if your mother and father at all those ages we just mentioned, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80 years of age, if they were to call right now and tell you to come right now to wash the dishes, you have to remain to make the salah because that is a haqq on Allah. That is the right of Allah. Then after that, as soon as you make the tasleem to the left, As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullah, no matter how old you are, you better get on the fastest subway or the fastest car or a bicycle and go straight to them, even if they call you from across the country to wash the dishes. This is the haqq that they have. This is the right that they have because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used them to allow you to come to this earth so that you may worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put this on our shoulders, brothers and sisters. We're getting closer to the month of Ramadan, the month of mercy, the month of maghfirah, the month of forgiveness, the month in which the gates of heaven are open, the month in which the gates of hell are closed and the shayateen are chained up. I tell you in the name of Allah standing on this minbar, no matter how many good deeds you do in that month, you can make all the qiyam or layl you want. You can make all of the tahajjud you want. You can stand at night all you want. You can give all of the charity you want to the point where your left hand doesn't know what your right hand is giving. You can make umrah for the whole month, every day, 30 days or 29, whatever Ramadan ends up being. You can do all of the righteous deeds fighting in jihad in the month of Ramadan. You can do whatever comes to your mind as mentioned in the Quran or in the authentic sunnah of our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But wallahi, watallahi, summa billahi, I swear by Allah, your mother and your father is your paradise or your hell. Your mother and your father is your paradise or your hell. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa salatu wa salam ala ashraf al-anbiya'i wal-mursaleen, nabiyyina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa ashabi ajma'in. We have a hadith, an athar that is collected by Imam al-Bukhari on the authority of Haythala ibn Mayyas, radiallahu anhu, who said, Kuntu ma'a najaddat, that I was with some of the people of the Najd ibn Amir al-Khariji, a people from a place called Haruriyya. He said, فَأَصَبْتُ ذُنُوبًا لَا أَرَاهَا إِلَّا مِنَ الْكَبَائِرِ, that I committed some acts. I was besieged by some acts that I didn't see them being anything else except major sins. وَقُلْتُ كَذَا لِإِبْنِ عُمَرِ رضي الله عنهما, and I said what I did to Ibn Umar. I told him what I had done. He said, what did you do? I said, كَذَا وَكَذَا, I did this and that. Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhuma said, لَيْسَتْ هَذِهِ مِنَ الْكَبَائِرِ هُنَّ تِسْعٌ. He said, these things that you've done, they're not the major sins. The major sins are nine. The major sins are nine. Then Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhuma began to cite those nine major sins. Number one, الْإِشْرَاكُ بِاللَّهِ, making shirk with Allah. The top on the nine, وَقَتْلُ النَّثَمَةِ, and killing a person without justification. And killing a person without justification. وَالْفَرَارُ مِنَ السَّحَفِ, and to flee from the battlefield. Number three, to flee from the battlefield. وَقَذْفُ الْمُحْصَنَةِ, number four, to unjustifiably accuse a righteous Muslim woman of zina. وَأَكْلُ الرِّبَى, number five, to consume and participate in interest. To consume and or participate in interest. Number six, أَكْلُ الْمَالِ الْيَتِيمِ, and to take unjustifiably the wealth of the orphan. To eat and devour the wealth of the orphan. Listen to these nine major sins, brothers and sisters. They're serious. These are not minor. These are major haram. Major sins. And then Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, وَالْإِلْحَادُ فِي الْمَسْجِدِ, and to do any types of acts of disobedience in the masjid. Kufr, shirk, bid'ah, etc. Especially in Masjid al-Haram. especially in the masjid where the Kaaba is. وَالَّذِي يَسْتَسْخِرُ And the one who makes sukhriya, the one who makes mockery of his brother and sister in Islam. The one who makes mockery of his brother and sister in Islam. And lastly, العقوق بالوالدين. Oh, بكاء الوالدين من العقوق. بكاء الوالدين من العقوق. Listen to this ninth major sin, brothers and sisters. The weeping and the crying of your father because you disrespected them. If your mother or your father weeps because, not wailing, not crying, just tears. If one tear comes out of your mother's eye because you disrespected her, this is a major sin in Islam. A major sin in Islam. And then Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhuma said, أَوَالِدُكَ حَيٌّ أَحَيٌّ وَالِدُكَ Is your mother, is your father alive? He said, عِنْدِ أُمِّي No, my mother's alive. He said, أَتَفْرَقُ مِنَ النَّارِ وَتُحِبُّ أَنْ تَدْخُلَ الْجَنَّةِ He said, do you fear going into the hellfire? And do you want to be admitted to the Jannah? He said, Wallahi, absolutely, I swear by Allah. And then Abdullah ibn Umar, radiallahu ta'ala anhuma said, فَوَاللَّهِ وَلَوْ أَلَنْتَ لَهَا الْكَلَامِ وَأَطْعَمْتَهَا أَتْطَعَامِ لَتَدْخُلَنَّ الْجَنَّةِ مَجْتَنَبْتَ الْكَبَائِرِ He said, I swear by Allah, you really want to stay away from the hellfire? You really want to go to paradise, O Muslims, who brag, who boast about how much they own this tower? How much they on the sunnah, how many verses of Quran they memorize, how much tahajjud they make, how much charity they make, how much charity they give, how many times they made umrah, how many niqabs they wear, or overgarments they wear. If you want to go to paradise and you want to stay out of the hellfire, he said to the man, if you were just to say kind words to your mother, and you fed your mother, just go to her house and make a tuna fish sandwich and put it in her mouth. لَتَدْخُلَنَّ الْجَنَّةِ مَجْتَنَبْتَ الْكَبَائِرِ You will surely enter into paradise as long as you don't commit major sins. And what are the major sins? بُكَاءُ الْوَالِدَيْنِ مِنَ الْعُقُوقِ Crying because you disrespected and disobeyed your mother and your father. So brothers and sisters in Islam, this is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put on our shoulders. You better catch yourself, brothers and sisters in Islam, before Allah takes you from this planet. You better rush to your mother and your father while they're still alive. And do what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا We have enjoined on the human being, وَوَصَّلْنَا الْإِنسَانَ بِوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا We have enjoined on the human being kindness to his parents. حَمَلَتْهُ أُمُّهُ وَهْنًا عَلَى وَهْنٍ His mother bore him and carried him pain on top of pain on top of pain. Oh, how I wish you brothers could see your wives when they have these babies. You brothers should go and watch your wife have that baby. If you see your wife have that baby when that baby comes from her womb, you will never mistreat your mother and disrespect your mother again. If you can see what pain she goes through, as Allah says, حَمَلَتْهُ أُمُّهُ وَهْنًا عَلَى وَهْنٍ How could you mistreat your wife who is a mother? How could you disrespect your mother? Pain on top of pain. وَفِصَالُهُ فِي عَامَيْنِ And then she fed him for 2 years. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ends that noble verse by saying, don't commit shirk with me. Treat your parents kindly. أَنُشْكُرْ لِي Give thanks to me. وَلِوَالِدَيْكَ So give thanks to me and your parents. And your parents. Allah connects the shukr, the thanks of your parents to himself. أَنِشْكُرْ لِي وَلِوَالِدَيْكَ وَإِلَيَّ الْمَصِيرُ Because eventually you're going to come back to me. Because eventually you're going to return to me. إِنَّ لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّ إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ Before the month of Ramadan begins, make amends with your mother and father before the month of Ramadan begins, because it might just be that Allah not allow you to leave this building. And if you have committed this atrocious act of disrespect, and disobedience to your parents, even if they're pagans, remember that your mother and father is your Jannah or your Nar. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us of those people who don't commit shirk with Him. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us of those people who are kind to our parents, who respect our parents, who cherish our parents, and make dua for our parents who are Muslims, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them the Jannah, and make dua for our parents that are non-Muslims, that may Allah guide them to Islam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us of those who stay away from all the major sins, and we ask you, O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to make our parents, whether they're Muslim or non-Muslim, the door to our Jannah. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.